I can love you with my eyes closed.
It's your girl T. Hey, before I even start the video, shout out to Amazon. I'm gonna have the link in the description. Check this out. Repping the classic show, A Different World, with the Hillman sweatshirt. Y'all should go out and get one. But whoo, do we have a topic for you all today? Let me turn this down just a little bit. This is actually something I saw on Instagram. I shared it with a friend. Shout out to my homegirl Danny. Y'all, we're gonna talk about the new blackface, apparently. They call it blackfishing. So I came across this video, and this video is, you know, pictures of, like, you know, pretty black girls. Oh, so I thought. There are Caucasian women who are actually going beyond tanning and transforming themselves into black girls. Like, this is like a Kardashian thing 2.0. Like, everybody knows about the Kardashians, the lip injections, the big booties, hips, thighs, breasts, all that. They're trying to have bodies like women of color, specifically black women and Latino women. And there's a group of girls that I've seen so far through this video. I'm gonna put this in my description. If you guys do not know what video I'm talking about, it's on Instagram. If you don't have an Instagram, please get one in order, or if you have a friend that has an Instagram, look, I'm going to have the link in the description so you all can see this video, because that really just turned my head. But I'm going to describe the video to you so the video talks about how there are white girls who are actually going beyond tanning, becoming chocolate color skin like me, starting up Instagram pages and actually saying that they're black girls, black girl magic. And come to find out, people have uncovered that they are actually Caucasian women. And it baffles me because it's so funny how you all want to be black, but yet when the time calls for you to be considered black, y'all don't want that. See, y'all want to look like us, but y'all don't want everything that comes with looking like us. I think that's very interesting to me. Because, like I said earlier, you got the lip injections. They want fuller lips like us. They want to have breasts. They want to have hips, thighs, and booty. And there, I ain't gonna lie, there's a couple of white women who are naturally thick. Shout out to y'all. But I'm talking about the ones who ain't thick. I'm talking about the Malibu Barbies that were born not as voluptuous as us, that don't look like us. But apparently now, the thing that you all talked about, this is what you want. Like, it's so crazy, and I'm gonna keep saying it baffles me, because it's like, when you see something on a black woman and you consider inappropriate or ghetto, but then you see it on the runway, it's considered high class and pretty. Like, I was so tired of seeing the picture of the bantu knots. Those who know about the bantu knots, the knots in your hair, and they consider that inappropriate or, you know, like unclean or not professional. But yet when you saw that on a runway, people consider it high class. Oh, that's new, that's, you know. Are you kidding me right now? Like, it's already crazy at the fact that there's black girls, our cousins, our little sisters, in schools that they are privileged to go to, these private schools, these prep schools, and they can't even, you know, wear their hair a certain way, and they get in trouble for it. But yet, if a white girl does the same thing, that's considered she's going through a phase, or, you know, she's just expressing herself. Are you kidding me? So you're telling me when we do something that's natural to us, you know, part of our culture, that's not considered appropriate to your standards? Like, I'm really tired of, you know, when you're around a different race, if they don't know you, you have to adjust yourself to feel comfortable around them. Why are you making them feel comfortable if they don't appreciate your values? They don't appreciate, you know, who you are and how you look. Like, look at me. I'm brown skin. I have full lips. I have a big nose. I have brown eyes. pretty brown skin. I'm shapely. And for, at one point in my life, I honestly didn't like how I look. But see, now in this new 2018 that I love about black women now, we're realizing that we are a gold standard. I love the fact that black women nowadays, we're realizing we are beautiful in our skin. We are beautiful the way God made us. And the fact that we love ourselves and we value our hips and our thighs and our breasts and our pretty chocolate colored skin and our pretty full lips and our big broad noses, we appreciate the features we have. Because at one point, y'all didn't like those features. But the fact that we do now, everyone's like, oh, I gotta get a big butt now. I gotta get big boobs now. Oh, I gotta seriously get tan. You know, I wanna be pretty like them. But it's I'm upset, but not upset. Like, I understand when you look at us and you admire how we look. I love the fact that you love the way that we look. But when you try to transform into being us and try to perpetrate us, and then what's crazy is they're getting money off us. Like, isn't it sad that they would not hire a black model, right? But they would get a white model and try to tan her up and put makeup on her to make her as dark as us. If you have to go through all that, why don't you just hire a black model? Like, come on now. If you have to go through all those hurdles to look black, just hire somebody black. Well, is there something wrong with these advertisers? Is there something wrong with the designers? Is there something wrong with the people that are having these campaigns that just can't fathom hiring someone African-American, but you want to make your models look African-American? Like, you want to have your models have froze. You want to have your models have bantu knots. You want your models to, you know, and what's crazy is when they Photoshop a lot of these models, they add weight to them. They add their hips to be a little wider. They add their, you know, thighs to be a little bigger. Their butt to be a little, you know, pronounced. And their breasts to be a little pronounced. They want them to look like that, but yet they don't want to hire someone that's naturally like that. Why is there a problem between that correlation? What's the big issue? What's the big problem? Is there something wrong with you hiring African Americans? Like, you want people to have ads to look like me, but you don't want to hire me? Like, what's the big deal? They're like, oh, I don't want a girl that's black, but I do want a girl that's brown. Like, now me saying that sounds very stupid, right? But that happens every single day. They bypass these gorgeous, beautiful creatures that God put on this earth, and yet you don't want to use us for good, but you want to bash us, or you want to put us in a bad light. Y'all want to talk about us when it's convenient, but y'all don't want to talk about us when we're doing good or something. Like, it's really kind of sad when big things happen. They were like, oh, power to the black girl, you know, long time coming. It shouldn't have taken so long for us to get the position that we have. Like, do you know the black woman in America has the biggest target on our backs right now? No, take that back. We've always had the biggest target on our backs. But yeah, we are the backbone of this country. Like, what more do you want us to do? And there was another video that I also saw called talking about why are black women always so angry? Well, honey, I mean, if you decided to be a black woman for a day and had to deal with the things that we have to go through, I think you would understand why we are upset. And then sometimes when people think that we're upset, we're not even upset. Like, it's so much more to... It's so much more to women trying to be African-American, portraying themselves to be African-American women, and they're not. But when something happens, they're quick to say, no, I'm Caucasian, or I'm American, or I'm not this, or I'm not that. But you weren't saying that when you were getting 2 million likes advertising for a black company who thought you were African American. You're getting paid off what we are, yet you're not us. Like, that's some serious hypocritical mess right there. Like it's... It annoys me. It really, really annoys me. It annoys me when I see that in pictures. And it's crazy because You know, the biggest example we have of that is the Kardashians. You know, everybody knows if you see the pictures of them when they were younger versus now, they got lip fillers. Their skin is a little like there's a little bit more complexion in them. You know, their butts are bigger, their hips are wider. It's like, and it's another, and it's just so, it's disgusting. In all honesty, if you have to go through all that to look like us, then something's wrong with you. Cause see, we had to learn to love ourselves. Apparently you gotta learn to love yourself too. That's all I'm saying. We've been through so much for 400 years to us to get to the point in our lives where we love how we look. And yet people still don't appreciate how we look. But when another race does it, y'all get approved of it. Y'all get the thumbs up. Y'all get the gold star. Oh, she's gorgeous. She's this. She's that. Oh my God. She's expressing her creativity. Are you kidding me right now? Are you serious? I'm tired of jumping over hoops to let people be comfortable around me. I shouldn't have to sit there and let my sister just be something that she's not. Like, if she wants to wear an afro and there's a problem with her wearing an afro, what's the problem? She wants to wear cornrows or braids or beads or bantu knots. But when another person does it who's not black, it's pretty, it's nice, it's cute. I'm like, in closing, is I love the fact that I'm black. I love the fact that I'm an African American woman. I love the fact that I'm a brown girl. I love the fact that I have a gap. I love the fact I have a bra. I love the fact that I have a cute, you know, wide nose with full lips. I love the fact that God made me who I am. I love me inside and out. And I hope one day my followers who are non-black, who are not brown girls, love themselves the way I love myself too. And like I always say, respect yourself and love yourself, because if you do not love yourself, no one else will. You can't paint a pretty picture and being fake about who you are, because eventually people will find out. You can't live in this fantasy world thinking you are something and you're not. It's sickening and you need help. Look, I know I'm always on these videos, but trust me, if you need to talk to somebody, reach out to me. That's all I'm saying. Well, look, you all, look, that's all I really need to say. I don't think I'm gonna make a part two video because I think I basically said what I need to say. But look, I love you all and you all be blessed, okay? I'll see you all next week.